Canada, we use surgery for treatment of femur fractures, and that's because it's the most effective method. But in low-resource settings, some people just don't have access to surgery, and so they're only really given the option to go into traction. We saw traction procedure in Kenya and Uganda, and to me it looked quite archaic and quite painful. What I realized was that traction was developed a very long time ago, and it has a lot of outstanding complications to it. Those haven't been addressed in all the time that it's used. So I felt that there was a large need to improve the method. We came back and formed the Femur Fracture Treatment Project. The team is very multidisciplinary. We have a medical student, a kinesiology student, a business student, and we have 6 mechanical engineering students. And that's because you really need input from all different fields.
It's really important for us to break down the problem. So what we've done is looked at a femur fracture. It's basically two bones that are overlapping that you need to pull apart. We started with really simple mechanisms, and as we've added all the details, we've had to consider making sure that you're developing a functional device that isn't going to cause more damage in the long run.
It's a really painful procedure, and sometimes with engineers, they forget that there's a human aspect to it.
At the time that I was introduced to this project, some of the designs didn't really work out biologically. And that's where my background comes in, because I can tell the team why a certain prototype might be better because it's missing critical arteries, how that would affect the bone, how tissue structure would be compromised in the patient for long term.
I think the ratio of technical skills to strategy skills is better with a business student or someone with more strategy experience on the team. You can develop a product that is totally functional and totally workable here in North America, and you can bring it somewhere else like Uganda, and it might not be feasible for them because the financing structure may be out of whack. And so having better insight into actually bringing it to ground is really good.
We really need to gain an in-depth understanding of what our device actually needs to accomplish. Ideally, we'd be able to go to Kenya or Uganda to observe how traction is done over an extended period of time. That's a huge time commitment, as well as takes a lot of money. And so it's pretty hard for us to do that. But the ability to kind of impact people's lives and to have the skills to do that would be such a great thing.